Welcome to another fun-filled episode. Today we're talking about phonetics. This looks pretty scary. So let's make a little bit of sense out of it. Yeah, let's go. Phonetics is the theory of sounds. So we're looking at in the textbook. In the dictionary, if you look in a lot of different dictionaries online too, you'll see the phonetic spelling of a word. So in the dictionary, that's like the theory of how you're supposed to pronounce it. So that's what we're looking at. Okay. So let's look at what we're going to discuss today. Why are we studying this? So what? That's my favorite question. What parts of the body are required to produce the sounds? What features do these have? And there are two main types. There's segments and syllables. We're going to do most of our focus on segments, which are consonants and vowels. So doesn't that sound exciting? Let's go. What three physical things are required for speech? So you've probably heard Morgan Freeman at some point. If you've heard him at all, you have his voice in your head, right? Interesting. First, you need a power source, so something to drive. Then you need a noise source, something to make the noise, and then a resonating chamber to actually help you pronounce, to help the sound make sense. Maybe. Okay. You don't have to memorize this stuff. Just think about it. Think about how it makes sense. You can always go back to your book and look, but you'll start thinking about it more and more. So here we have power source, lungs, air, pulmonic sounds. There are, in most languages, only pulmonic sounds. Then there are some non-pulmonic clicks, but it's rare. I don't know how to pronounce it, but I think it's cool that, like, also clicks that maybe you've heard this. So power source, noise source, phonation, vocal cords, right? The sound waves travel through space. So your vocal cords are making your sound, your sounds travel better. So if your vocal cords are weak, then the sounds will be weaker. I can give you a personal example. My dad had voice box cancer, and luckily they were able to save his voice, but it is diminished. So he actually cannot really yell. It's interesting. He can't really, like, so when he talks, you have to listen carefully. Even though when you talk to him, you have to talk loud because he doesn't hear you, right? So larynx and vocal cords, and then you need a resonating chamber. So where is it coming out? So you have your lungs, goes up to your voice box, then it goes up and comes out, right? So your mouth, it's important. Your teeth, your tongue, your throat, your glottis, if you're, some people pronounce that, or guh is back there, okay? All right, so three things required for speech. You start with power source, then you go to what they call here a vibrator, what creates the noise, vocal cords, larynx, and then the resonator, Okay. And then it comes out of your mouth. Some people use their nose a lot to create that nasally sound. My aunt does that. Okay. So let's go on to the segments. Remember, we have consonants or vowels. This is very exciting, I know. Okay. Consonants. Consonants stop airflow. Almost always, generally. And they're generally found, this is in English, in the onset, which is the beginning of a word, b, beginning, or the coda of a syllable, the end of a syllable, beginning. Okay. In some languages like English, a consonant can take up the entire rhyme or be held for a full beat. Think about that. Okay. So, how do they classify consonants? This actually does matter because remember when I was telling you about ice and eyes? I remember what my other example was. Pants, like pants that you wear, and pans that you cook with. So my husband can't pronounce the z sound. He doesn't pronounce it. It's not a common sound in Spanish. And he's a native Spanish speaker, so he asked me about, I don't remember what he was saying, but he asked me about the pans. And I thought he was talking about me cooking with pans, but no, he was talking about pants. No, maybe it was the other way around. Yeah. Pants, because pants has the s sound, and pans has the z sound. So you probably never thought that those two words would ever be related, but now you know. Okay, so consonant, but so the consonants there, the S and the Z, right? The S, is it voiced? No. The Z is voiced. Z. Place of articulation, where here does the consonant sound come from? Okay. This helps you if you're trying to learn a certain accent. People who play movie roles and try to learn certain accents, they have a voice coach and they study this, they try. Then there are other actors that just kind of do it and it's bad. Right, so here we have place and then manner. What different ways can we make them resonate? So this is kind of scary, but I'll just explain it to you and know it's in your book and you can look it up, okay? These are phoneme consonants, okay? Manner of articulation goes down. It could be voiceless, voiced, or it's a stop, it's a fricative, it's an affricate. Nasal, right? Liquid, glide. Okay, so glide would be like, yeah. Then you have place of articulation. So the way that it's articulated, and then the place, which is this, okay? So bilabial, bah, to lips come together, right? P, b. Sounds different. P, b. I'll bet you're doing it at home. I like to hear you. Labiodental. So we have the fricatives are under that one. F, v. That's another sound Spanish does not generally have, the v, f, v, dental, teeth, dental, f, the. So think, this. So similar, but different. And if somebody makes a mistake, you know it, right? Here we have alveolar, t, duh. So these are like in direct opposition as far as voiceless and voiced, or they also say unvoiced, voiced. Fricative, s, alveolar. So if you think about the place that in here that you're resonating the sound from here, that place, all these letters are the same place. But like with the t and the s, you're not putting in the voice with it. Oh, okay. So palatal, sh, sh, zh, zh. And here we have affricate, ch, ch, voiceless, j, j. I try. Velar, here you have k, g. So same place of articulation, but once voice, once voiceless. Glottal. For some people, it's farther back. There's also another one that is, which is actually voice, so it's pretty cool. But obviously, I can't pronounce that one, so just don't be scared of that little thing. And here's another look at it. This actually includes more, but I didn't want to scare you too much. But you do have access to this as well. It's called IPA, International Phonetic Alphabet. If you Google it, you're going to come up with some sort of beer first. IPA. But then the next one will be International Phonetic Alphabet. Cool. I'm thirsty. Okay. We're done with consonants. Now let's go on to vowels. Vowels generally have unrestricted or lightly restricted airflow. They're always in the nucleus. Inside the nucleus is the middle, right, of a syllable. Almost always voiced and sonorant. I think in English they are always voiced. Here's an example of Japanese. And I'm sorry, I don't know how to pronounce it, but it's not voiced. I think it's this E at the end. It just, yosh, but I'm not sure, but it's still there. It's kind of like, it's not a vowel, but the K in no, I know something, the K is silent, but we know it's there, but why is it spelled that way? I don't know. Okay, history. Speech sounds. How do we describe vowels? So we just describe consonants. Now we're going to do vowels. You have height, backness, roundness, tenseness. English vowels are horrible. So my husband does not know how to say beach. Like somewhere you go on vacation, the beach. It all sounds the same. Bitch, beach, it's like me with pen and pen, pen and pin, right? I have to think about it. So it's kind of entertaining at our house sometimes. So let me show you what this is. Other languages have a limited range of sounds for vowels, right? So when I studied phonetics, the first time I ever studied it, I studied it in Spanish, and it's so much easier, but I'm gonna try to make some sense out of this for you. So this little diagram shows you where your tongue is. Front, central, back, high, mid, low. Make any sense? Okay. And then these are the lax vowels, and around are the tense vowels. So that doesn't really make much sense. So let's show you this, which is really scary, but I promise you're going to appreciate this. C, E, E. Think about where you're pronouncing it in your mouth. It's high, it's front, E. Say, say, it's mid, right? Front, sigh, like sigh, sigh, soy, soybeans, soy, sow your wild oats, or so what? So. Back. Kind of mid. Interesting. Just don't worry too much about it. Just think about it for a minute and realize that, oh, there's some science behind this, right? We're not just making up stuff. This is kind of scary, but this is actually the English vowels. Really scary. Okay. Syllables. What's a syllable? Well, a syllable is consonants and vowels together to come. They come together in one syllable, right? So there are certain rules about syllables. How do they behave in syllables? You have the onset, which is the beginning, rhyme, which is the nucleus and coda together. Okay, the nucleus, the middle, and then the coda is the end. If you study music, you know what coda is. So generally, you start with consonants and then go to vowels. And most of the time, you end with a consonant, but not always. It's just a natural way that syllables are produced, right? So why are we studying this? Obvious. It's pretty cool. So what? So this is important because if you're trying to attain a different type of accent, if you want to sound more like another group, even if it's like me, I'm from the South. I could speak Southern if you want me to. But if I want to fit in with the people that I live around now, and I think that's just a natural thing that we want, then I don't really pronounce things that way. I learn a different way. Yeah. And that's important because of society and the way that they view people who speak a certain way. So if I say, I'm gonna fry my chicken in some oil, that sounds different from, I'm gonna fry my chicken in some oil, right? Next episode is suprasegmentals. We're gonna talk more about syllables and how we put them together. Ciao!